even know if I do, I'm gonna need to get a pillow. Some company has reached out to me and they want me like to like make videos about their product.
Mm-hmm.
But one product they want me to do is like an eye massager. But the thing was like, you don't really show their face as much. I was like, not that I don't show their face as much. It's like, one, you don't see their faces for most of the massage because that's not the focus. But two is like when you're laying face down, you kind of see the face, but you also kind of don't. Like you just don't look the same when someone's like looking over your face like that.
Yeah.
But he makes such funny faces. I think I'm gonna get a pillow so that he's propped up. Right, I think you have a lot of fibrosis here. I feel like I can feel it with my bare hands. Let's see. Yeah, you can hear it too.
Yeah. It's making music.
You're responding well. You notice you don't have much here. It's more on the inside, kind of going into the elbow. You actually don't have as much up here. Most people have a lot right around here. It's like right there.
Huh.
And that bicep tendon. There's some, but you don't have enough. Some more with this. Okay, not a lot up there. You don't have a lot of foam that fibrosis where most people have it. Some here, this is generally where most people have it. It's anterior deltoid.
I wonder what I'm doing different.
And then yeah, a lot of people have it here. Because from my understanding of it, the scar tissue is like it comes from your body healing. So like your body overheals and leaves too much tissue. And when I scrape, it encourages your body to reabsorb that tissue. I like to think of it as like if you broke a vase and you tried to glue it back together, but you did a bad job. And you just kind of had glue, like just kind of sticking out everywhere. That's like, to me, that's the fibrosis. And you look like you were mauled by something. You can definitely take your shirt off and go home and put something on your guy and go, I think I need to go to the hospital.
I've seen on YouTube what it can do, so I know what I was getting myself into.
Mm-hmm. Well, you handled it pretty well. I think my Instagram is better, but I've started posting the same stuff on Instagram as YouTube Shorts. So those are kind of more like my highlights. So this is the one you think you have tear?
No, it's still my right one.
Because you do have limited range of motion, which is very common right there. I wouldn't say you're tougher than like the bodybuilders I work with, which is true, but I wouldn't also say bodybuilders are kind of some of the wimpier people I work with. I would say if a guy has a six pack, is really muscular, but he still has a six pack, they like freak out on the table. They can't take a lot of pressure. But if a guy is muscular, like he doesn't have a six pack, they're tougher. And then if he does CrossFit, he just kind of actually enjoys me. They're like, they're masochists. I'm convinced that if I started hitting CrossFit athletes with a bat, they would like put me in their will. A little bit more, you're not arching your back. So now what we're going to do is when I say go, you're going to have your arm up like this.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to go all the way back as far as you can, and then you're going to go back up and you're going to stop right here. Go. That's good.
Yep, that was tremendous. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. That's good. And some people are just stoic like that. Until I twisted my ankle so bad, I thought I had broken something. And then I was in the hospital. At one point, like 40% of the words that came out of my mouth were, "Why shit fuck hurt?" And then I learned there's a point where you go from like cursing to just like you just start crying. It felt like somebody was trying to rip the bones out of my foot.
Did you say you broke your ankle?
I did not. They said it was just a strain, but I could not walk for 3 days.
Yeah.
So it was a pretty bad strain. Like, I remember, like, I rolled it and I thought it was, you know, like, oh, that sucks. And then I think what happened was that because my shoes were on, that was compression. And so when I went home and go to sleep, you know, I took my shoes off, there was no compression. I woke up to go use the bathroom and I couldn't stand up. And I live alone, so like, I called like the paramedics and I had to crawl to the door. Like, I literally could not stand up. And they, you know, took me there, did an x-ray or whatever they did, and gave me crutches, wrapped me up, told me what's going on. And I couldn't stand up without holding on to the crutches for like 2 or 3 days. And that scared me because I had never been to the point where I was injured and actually could not just like even stand up.
Yeah.
Amazing. You have so little there. You do have more here. You can probably feel that. You did not have that on the other side. But here, you're pretty smooth. A little bit here, not. This is like a baby. And it's not as, he's here, but it's not as much here. But that could be that you're not using this arm as much, so you wouldn't have as, there wouldn't be as much to heal.
Yeah, I can tell you, I've been putting most of my weight on this arm lately with that injury here. That was good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, see, I'm not sure what's causing that. Because normally that's the pecs, but it doesn't feel like the pecs, just the way the tension is. Could be the pecs, though. I feel like it's coming from the shoulder itself, though. Because most of the time when you have someone's arm at an angle like this and they can't go all the way down, you feel a ton of tension just right here. You have some tension, but not that much tension. So there's something else holding it. Have the same range of motion, but you're also not arching your back, which is good. People will arch their back when they don't have the range of motion here. So sometimes people come in, they lift their arm up, and I'm like, I can tell that when you do a overhead press or military press, you like arch your back. And they're like, how do you know? Because like, you can't go all the way back. Same thing on this side.
Okay.
Go. You're starting to sweat a little bit.
Yeah, it's my pain response.
That's good. I'm a lot further back though.
All right.
my big problem with a lot of ASMR videos is when they massage, is really more like this.
Mm-hmm.
And just watching that, just ugh. It's like one of those things that you're like much more like critical of your own profession. About people who are musicians and have a hard time listening to music because of that.